Welcome back, and now we have news from sports. The Mahindra Youth Football Challenge is set to kick off with 32 participating school teams from all over Goa on Wednesday. The tournament has been played in 6 cities and Goa is the final stop. After the national championships, 2 to 4 youngsters will have the opportunity to go to Celtic Football Academy in Scotland. The intra-city leg of the Mahindra Youth Football Championship will begin on the 16th of February and the finals will be played on the 26th of February.
This tournament is part of Mahindra's way of giving back to Indian football after the team disbanded and quit the I-League last season. Sriram Ramchandra of Mahindra briefed press persons on the details of the Youth Football Challenge.
We made an announcement last year that we will get into grassroots football development, and we did quite a bit of groundwork before we started this partnership. We believe that this is a very unique event because this event is not only providing a platform, critical coaching skills from a world-class football club, Celtic Football Club.
The 32 school teams selected in this tournament have come from DSYA School Championship. The tournament is divided into 4 zones: Bardez, Ilias, Murmugao and Salset. Here is the list of school teams that will participate. The matches will be of 50 minutes in length, and from the quarterfinal stage will be 60 minutes in length divided in 2 halves. Winners will get a prize money of 30,000 rupees. Former India greats like Fortunato Franco and Bruno Coutinho were present at the press conference as well. Franco said he was deeply hurt when Mahindra disbanded from the I-League.
And it saddened me very, very much. My heart virtually broke when both the teams folded. And here was Mahindra's shining example to give back to give it back to football what they have earlier done. That was the ray of hope, a shining light.
Our sports reporter Nikhil Pereira with video journalist Omkar Falari from Panji.
The Goa Football Association is in the final stage of completing the formalities for the expansion of the Dulair football ground. It will now be only a matter of time before the full-fledged work begins at this prime footballing venue in Mapsa.
The GFA president Srinivas Dempo revealed the progress in their bid to provide a facelift to Dulair football ground.
So we are going to have the shades for both the stands that are right now in progress. And then the expansion project also, we have submitted our papers to PDA. The PDA in turn has put favorable recommendations and sent it to town and county planning because we've asked for certain exemptions. So hopefully within the next 1 month that should get cleared. And then the executive committee will apply its mind which is the best way to go ahead in terms of getting it built on a boot basis or, you know, issuing expressions of interest to builders.
The GFA, meanwhile, is yet to appoint a paid secretary, but a technical officer has been appointed, disclosed Tempo.
We did interview 3 to 4 candidates from the older panel, from the older list of applicants, which was done on Saturday. I cannot give you more details than that because the panel has to submit a report to the executive committee and executive committee has to take a decision. But I am hopeful that whoever it is, a secretary should be in place by the month of March. And in the meantime, we've gone ahead and appointed a technical officer by the name of Anup Abraham, who is hopefully going to join by the 1st of March. So, and he'll look after the entire youth development activities of GFA.
Our sports reporter Nikhil Pereira with video journalist Anil Sanidhi from Panji.
Mandovi boys of Mapsa have won the second All Goa Kunkule Premier League Cricket Tournament. It was organized by the youth of Kunkule in the memory of Islinda Alemão at the Kunkule ground.
A total of 36 teams took part in the tournament. Urban Development Minister Joki Alemão was the chief guest for the final. Mandovi boys clashed with politics in the finals. Batting first, Mandovi scored 46 runs in 3 overs. In reply, politics could only manage 26 runs. The winners received rupees 30,000. While the runners-up were presented rupees 20,000, former cricketers were felicitated on the occasion. Former Ranji cricketer Debashish Bagchi was also felicitated. Here are some of the highlights of the finals.
Umpire और इस बीच मोर दिया गया, इनको कैच होने की संभावना है लेकिन कैच नहीं कर पाए, एक रन पूरा हो चुका है, दूसरे रन की गुंजाइश बनाई है और दूसरा मिड ऑफ के क्षेत्र में, मिड ऑफ के लॉन्ग ऑफ के क्षेत्र में बुलाया, सिर्फ 3 रन बने हैं जबकि दूसरे ओवर जा रहे हैं, काफी बढ़िया स्कोर, इस बार मौका नहीं मिलेगा, ये नामुमकिन बात बनती गई है, पॉलिटिक्स नाइन को और इस बीच मोर दिया गया इनको बॉल के बाहर है ये, और इस बीच अगली गेंद फिर एक बार कैच होने की संभावना और इसी के साथ राजेश आउट हो गए खंडवी को, इस बीच आनंद गए हैं और आनंद जर चुके हैं और बाउंड्री पर सीपीएल।
अ रिपोर्टर फ्रॉम कुकड़ी रमेश नाइक राउत।
And with this, we come to an end of this news bulletin. Take care and keep watching Prudent Media. Till the next time, goodbye.